right, we're gonna get started. Goodness, I feel no matter where I put the camera, I always am cutting off my head. Because I want to stand so much closer, but I have to stand way back here. Oh. All right. Let's do a little bit of a warming up, although it is plenty warm outside already. So unless you're inside with air conditioning, maybe you just want to stay in your seat, honestly, because it's pretty toasty. And now our arms go up in the air. Let's do one spin and then freeze. And again. Very nice. Now before we're done warming up, we're also going to do a little bit of playing pretend. So first, we're going to pretend to be a cat. Show me, how does a cat walk? They're very dainty and agile, right? They walk ever so carefully, and maybe they take a little bath. They do that because they give themselves a lick, and then like this. And now we're going to be a bat. Not like a baseball bat, but like a bat that flies in the sky. So flap your wings and fly around. Here we go, here we go, here we go, here we go. We're flying, 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 flying. Oh my goodness, my head keeps getting cut off. There we go. That's better. Okay, we've been a cat, we've been a bat. Next, we're going to pick up our favorite hat. Give it a pat. Oh. And as you give your hat a pat, we're going to give your belly a rub. Now this can take some practice, so it's worth working on to get your hand on your head patting and the hand on your belly rubbing. Oh goodness, there we go. So now we're giving our belly a rub. Next we need to hop into the tub. And once you're in the tub, give your body a scrub. Wash that dirt away. Scrub, 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 scrub. Don't forget to get behind your ears. Okay, I'm feeling nice and clean. Now, I don't know if you noticed, but there was a special thing happening with the words that I chose. We were a cat, a bat, we put on our special hat, we gave it a pat, we gave our belly a rub, hopped in the tub, and then gave our bodies a scrub. So I'll let you think about that for one moment while we're gonna sing our Playtime theme song. And then we'll get back to what was special about those words. I feel so far away today. It's time for playtime, playtime, everyone. It's time to read a book and have some fun. It's time to sing a song and dance and run. It's time for playtime, everyone. It's time for playtime, playtime, everyone. It's time to read a book and have some fun. It's friends this morning, I had a playtime session. And I forgot to sing the playtime song. I forgot until after we read the story. But anyway, we were talking about the special words we used in our warm-up. Cat, bat, hat, pat, rub, tub, scrub. We used a lot of rhyming words. So rhyming words are words that sound alike. So for the purpose of our story today, we're going to have two words that end the same way, but they start with a different sound. So our story today is called There's a Wocket in My Pocket. So there's a Wocket that starts with a W, a W sound, in my pocket that starts with a P sound. But they both end with the sound Wocket. Now, to be honest, there are lots of silly made-up words in here, and that's part of the fun of Dr. Seuss. But let's hop in here and let's see all of the fun rhymes that Dr. Seuss has written for us. There's a Wocket in my pocket. Look at that Wocket sticking out of his pocket. How silly. Did you ever have the feeling there's a wasket in your basket? Or a neuro in your bureau? Or a wasit in your closet? Well, I've never seen any of these things. Sometimes I feel quite certain there's a jerton in the curtain. Look, there's someone hiding back there. And sometimes I have the feeling there's a zlock behind the clock. And that zelf up on that shelf, I've talked to him myself. We had three words there that rhymed. Zelf, shelf, myself. That's the kind of house I live in. There's a nink in the sink. And a zamp in the lamp. And they're rather nice, I think. Some of them are very friendly. I like the yacht in the pot, but that yodel in the bottle, some are friendly, some are not. That is not friendly at all. We don't spit water in our friends' faces. Oh. I like the zabel on the table and the gare under the chair, but that bofa on the sofa, well, I wish he wasn't there. All those nubbirds in the cupboards, they're good fun to have about. But that noothbrush on my toothbrush, him I could do without. Could you imagine trying to brush your teeth with this giant noothbrush on top of your toothbrush? I don't know how this little boy is even holding that up. The only one I'm really scared of is that bug under the rug. And that quiminy up the chimney. I don't like him. Not at all. It makes me sort of nervous when the Zoll scoots down the hall. But the yeps on the steps, they're great fun to have around. And so are many, many other friends that I have found. Hello, Miss Karen. Like the teller and the kneller and the geller and the deller and the beller and the weller and the zeller in the cellar. Which is another fancy word for basement. And the geeling on the ceiling. I don't think I have any of those. You should take a look. Let's take a peek up on the ceiling. Okay, let's see. Is there a ceiling on your ceiling? There is not one on mine. Whew. And the shower in my shower. Oh my goodness. Is any part of his home free of creatures? And the Zillow on my pillow. I don't care if you believe it. That's the kind of house I live in, and I hope we never leave it. Oh, the end. And actually, this storybook has two little bonus rhymes right inside the front cover before you get to the beginning of the story. It says that there's a findo in my window and a nook gase in my bookcase. So to be quite honest, I have never heard of any of those creatures, and I have a feeling Dr. Seuss made them up. But he made them up so that they would rhyme with all the things he mentions in the story. So you could have some fun rhyming. How about, I think I know some rhymes that our friends in preschool probably have heard before. So can you help me finish these rhymes? Oh, I forgot it for a moment. There we go. Hey diddle diddle, the cat and the fiddle. The cow jumped over the moon. Yes, Dr. Seuss. The dog laughed to see such sport, and the dish ran away with the spoon. I bet you did a very good job with that. How about, let's try another one. Little Miss Muffet. We ever heard Little Miss Muffet before? Little Miss Muffet sat on a tuffet, eating her curds and whey. Along came a spider who sat down. Where did he sit down? Beside her, and frightened Miss Muffet away. I bet you knew some of those rhymes. Oh. Because rhyming is in lots of songs, it is in lots of books and stories and nursery rhymes that we all know. And you know what? I bet we could make up our own rhymes. Let's do a Dr. Seuss style rhyme, okay? Let's start with hair. Hair is a word we know. We know what hair is. But if we wanted to be like Dr. Seuss, we could say there's a something in my hair. So let's think of a word that rhymes with hair. It could be real or it could be made up. I had some friends suggest to me on Monday when I did this with my friends at Early Connections. They said the word dare, bear. What else did they say? I remember bear. Bear was really the favorite. So we think of something else. You're welcome to let me know. But for now, we're gonna go with bear. Bear. So we can say that there's a bear in my hair. Do you see it? Can you get it out for me, please? Honestly, I don't know how a bear is fitting in my hair. There's really not all that much of it. But if you could just, if you could just grab it real quick for me. Okay, thank you. That's much better. Okay, let's see. What else could we rhyme with? What about, I'm here at my mom's house, cat sitting. So little George the cat is around here somewhere. He doesn't like the sound of the slide whistle, so I'm not surprised he didn't come out here now. Let's see what else we could rhyme with cat. Earlier we used bat, pat, and hat. Let's think of a new word. Something we could rhyme with cat. I don't know if you can hear that, but my mom's phone is ringing. Sorry, busy. Oh my goodness. What about a rat? there's a rat chasing my cat. That's not a very friendly rat. Oh, my heavens. Oh, no, 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 no. Okay. The rat is done chasing my cat. The bear is out of my hair. I think it's time for another made-up word. This one we're going to take to Mary Poppins. She's got a very famous, made-up, very long, awesome word. It goes like this. Supercalifragilistic. Expialidocious. If you never heard that before, maybe you thought I was done, but nope, it's very long. So let's try that again. Supercalifragilistic. Expialidocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Oh, it makes for a very fun and very fast song. So we're gonna do a little bit of movement to this wonderful song. And we're gonna say the word supercalifragilisticexpialidocious a lot of times. And each time we say it in the song, we're going to go like this. Take your arms up and around. We're gonna go supercalifragilistic. We have all that time to bring our arms all the way up. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Let's try it slow one more time. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Now the song is much faster than that, so let's try it a little bit faster and supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Oh, I forgot how it went for one moment. Let's try that again. Here we go. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Nice. Now, after we land on our hop, we're gonna just bounce in our spot when we do the um-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de- sounds. And it really does get very fast.
It's...
Hop, hop, hop. There we go, get a little bounce.
Because I was afraid to speak, well, I was just a man. My father gave me.
He was afraid. Let's be afraid.
But then when they opened the word to say, we ain't got those.
This is how it goes. And supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Quite atrocious.
If you say it loud enough, you're always self-conscious.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
He's traveled all around the world.
Traveling around the world, here we go!
Use his word, Lord would say there goes a clever gent.
When you some mortal Rogers pass a time of day with me, I say be special right and this way off the altitude.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
If you say it loud enough, you'll always have a cautious. Oh my goodness! Miss Maeve needs a nap. Oh, I made it all the way through. Oh, friends. And now Miss Maeve needs a nap. Listen, sir, at least I'm getting my cardio in for the day. Okay, so, friends, we have read our story. We sang our playtime song. I remembered it today. We made up some of our own rhymes. We did a new dance. We got a workout in, despite it being like 90 degrees. Whew. I think it's just about time to sing goodbye, friends. So, because we have a slightly different schedule, we won't have playtime on Facebook on Friday or on Monday, but next Wednesday, 1 week from today, we will have another playtime. And if I'm not mistaken, I do believe it's Miss Karen has a special Father's Day story for us. Yes, that's next week. So be sure to tune in, get your papas, sit them down with you, and they can enjoy some playtime. And as we are saying goodbye, let's sing our goodbye song. We're gonna wave goodbye, say goodbye, friends. We'll see you in 1 week. For joining me for playtime. And Miss Karen will see you next Wednesday.